St. Anthony, Miracle and Meaning, Day 13. A very happy feast of St. Anthony to all of you. Today, June 13th, we celebrate the Feast of St. Anthony. Today, let us reflect upon the great example that St. Anthony is to us. As you know, after the death of St. Anthony, in the year 1231, on 13th of June, a Tuesday it was, that he died. So on that day, on his death, they bought the body and kept it in the Mater Dei Chapel, Mother of God Chapel. And they kept the body waiting for the funeral because they believed to give this great saintly person a better place. His body should receive a good place. Henceforth, the basilica was under construction. At least if it was partially constructed, they wanted to keep the body there. In the meanwhile, the whole region of Padua was weeping because they looked at St. Anthony as a father, and he was their father, father in faith, because that person inculcated faith in them. Before encountering St. Anthony, they were namesake Christians. But after encountering St. Anthony, they became real Christians, followers of Christ, Catholics in true sense. Henceforth, he was their father, and they were crying the death of their father. And finally came the day when they were burying him in the basilica. So when they were burying him in the basilica, one woman, her name to be noted, Kuniza her name was. She came to the tomb, and on her shoulder there was a big tumor. That swelled, the tumor was there. The tumor was such big that she couldn't walk properly. She had to use a crutch one side, and somehow she came and she just prostrated in front of the tomb, and she started weeping and praying. After some time, she noticed that the swell on her shoulder was gone and her shoulder was normal. She was healed. This miracle of Kuniza is seen as one of the first miracles that happened at that tomb, where thousands of miracles happened later. It looked as a pebble which started a huge storm. A pebble of wave which took the world by storm by the miracles of this great saint. Reflection. Today, on the feast day of St. Anthony, we are called to reflect upon this great truth of friendship with Christ. Why did St. Anthony gain so much of leverage, so much of popularity, so much of name around the world? No other saint has such great name. After Mother Mary, we know St. Anthony's popularity is huge, because he was a friend of Christ. Because he had that intimacy with Christ and he surrendered his life for Christ. So it is very good to look at St. Anthony. It is very good to pray and ask him to pray for us. Good. It is very good to receive miracles through the intercession of St. Anthony. But it would be best to become another St. Anthony. It would be best to follow his example and to become friends of Christ forever. Amen. So dear brethren, let's close our eyes. I offer all the devotees of St. Anthony today in this prayer. And thank you for watching all these videos for 13 days. So today I pray for all of you who have watched the videos. And I ask you to please forward it. It's not only for these 13 days. So these 13 videos you can forward to anybody who wants to grow in faith, 13 miracles that we reflected upon. Eternal Father God, I ask you to bless all your children who are praying right now. You have given us a great example in the name of St. Anthony, who while on earth and even now has vouched and has made so many miracles possible in the lives of your children. Today we pray that all your children may move from miracle to meaning, May they move towards Christ, and may they move towards friendship with Christ forever. We ask for all the intentions of the devotees who would be coming to St. Anthony's Church or everywhere in the world, from St. Anthony's Basilica in Padua to every St. Anthony's shrine and church and chapel all over the world. We pray that through the intercession of St. Anthony, their prayers be heard according to the holy will of God. Amen.